नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटियाओं। मायसेल्फ जेवीएन ज्योति कुमावत, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक कंटेंट एनालिसिस, विच इज़ फ्रॉम पेडागोजी ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल साइंस एंड फ्रॉम द प्रोग्राम बीएससी बीएड सिक्स सेमेस्टर। सो कंटेंट एनालिसिस इज़ ए टर्म विच इज़ यूज टू डिज़ाइन आवर कंटेंट और टैक्स इन ए सिस्टमेटिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग वे, so that students can understand very easily that content. Here is a description for this. Content analysis is a kind of tool which is used to study the extent of some concept or words present in the textual or visual forms. Texts include various documents, books, newspaper, article, etc. Visual include like advertisement, theater, movie, etc. So analysis can be done on any communication source which occurs, and this content analysis include a systematic observation and reading of text or other artifacts which are classified according to label or codes. We can say in subunits or subtopics. So codes are there to reveal the extent of different meaningful and interesting patterns. After classifying different media under codes, a researcher can find out then proportions of patterns in the text. Correlation between the pattern also revealed. And this content analysis has a broad techniques that have some specific types of questions. And these questions are as which data is to be being studied, how will the data explain, what is the revealed context, the data is taken from what population, what thing is to be measured, what are the limitations for the analysis. So these questions help to design our content analysis. Now here are some goals of content analysis. Reduce huge amount of disorganized content. Explain the characteristics of the content. This content analysis and identify and showcase important part of the content. This also supports some kind of arguments. This also show the study relationship and trend in multimedia and text. This also identify the communication trends or intention of an individual, institution or group. And this also help explain behavior and attitudinal response to communications. And this content analysis at last also determine emotional and psychological state of group or even an individual person. Now there are some importance for content analysis. Here is described as today's reader are very smart. We can say students. And they look for unique things which are easy to understand and useful if they read. That's why content analysis help you to put in content that matches to the user's need in the best possible manner. Helps you to fulfill specific interest and needs of your target's audience. Now here, qualitative content analysis mainly helps you to make your content quality finer. Like whenever you need to bring in more fresh flavor, it can happen by putting in an interesting story which will keep the readers bound till the end and then make them pass it forward. And this qualitative content analysis also helps you to work towards your target's audience, and thus you will be able to gain their views. It also helps you to polish your work and tone it according to the end. Now here there are three types of researcher problem in use of the content analysis. First, analyzing larger volume of text. How to analyze these texts in a content analysis form. Second, studying or analyzing something from past, like historical documents or some old television broadcast, etc. Yeah, this is a big problem for this. How can we design the past historical documents in a content? नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज रिलीविंग पैटर्न एंड एविडेंस विच आर डिफिकल्ट टू बी नोटिस थ्रू नॉर्मल ऑब्जर्वेशंस. दीज वर थ्री प्रॉब्लम रिसर्चर प्रॉब्लम ऑफ द कंटेंट एनालिसिस. नाउ हियर आर डिस्कस बिलो इन टू टाइप्स ऑफ एनालिसिस कंटेंट एनालिसिस. फर्स्ट कंसेप्चुअल एंड सेकेंड रेशनल. इन कंसेप्चुअल वॉट इज दिस इज द done to establish the essence and the frequency of concepts inside a text. And traditionally this content analysis is seen as conceptual analysis in this a particular concept is selected for the examination. Its number of appearances is checked within the recorded text. Rational analysis is famous for its different techniques and thus it provides flexibility to the researcher. And researchers can select their procedure depending on the nature of the project. Once a procedure is tested, then it can be compared among different populations. This type of content analysis prolongs a high degree of statistical rigor and doesn't even lose the richness of detailed apartment. Now here are advantage and disadvantage of the content analysis. Directly look in advantage, you can see directly looks the communication through transcripts of text, so it gets on the central part of social interaction. It can allow both qualitative and quantitative operations. It provides variable culture and historical insights over the time via analysis of text. It permits a close relation between texts which can change between particular categories and relationship. In disadvantage, you can observe as it can take lot of time to design, because we need a particular idea for this. That's why this can take lot of time. Second disadvantage, sometimes it might result in some error, generally when we rational analysis is done. And third disadvantage, leans too often towards words counts. And last, sometimes become difficult to computerize or automate. So, I hope you all enjoy this digital session, which is powered by the Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. If you have any queries and questions, then comment in the comment box. Thank you.